In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about active site of enzyme. First, what is active site? Active site is a special pocket or cleft present on enzyme. So, it is a special pocket or cleft which is present on enzyme. Suppose this is the enzyme. And on this enzyme, this special pocket or cleft is present. So, this particular region is called as a active site. Now, let's say this enzyme is required for catalyzing this reaction, that is conversion of substrate S to the product P. So, enzyme needs to first bind with the substrate. So, first requirement is the binding with substrate. Once substrate is bound with the enzyme, then enzyme needs to work on the substrate so that it can either make or it can break bonds, right? So, second requirement is making or breaking bonds. So, these both functions or both actions are carried out at the active site only. And for that, active site has a two region. One is the binding site, and second one is the catalytic site. Remember the term binding site, catalytic site, and active site. All these three terms are different. What this binding site does? Binding site is for the binding with the substrate, whereas for the catalytic site, where actual catalysis occur, and that is mostly making or breaking the bonds, or both the things, making and breaking the bonds, right? So, this combination of binding site and catalytic site makes up this active site. Now, when substrate binds with the enzyme, that binding is through the weak non-covalent interactions. So, there are various weak interactions occur between substrate and enzyme, and these are mostly van der Waals force or van der Waals interaction, then electrostatic bond, there may be hydrogen bonds, or there may be hydrophobic interactions. So, all these weak interactions are responsible for the binding of substrate with the enzyme. Now, let us see that how this active site is created on an enzyme. We know that enzymes are a protein, and proteins, that means polypeptide chain, which is made up of polymer of amino acids, right? Now, this polypeptide chain, it undergoes extensive folding and gives rise to tertiary structure. Now, various structural organization of protein I had already discussed in the playlist titled as a protein chemistry, right? So, because of the tertiary structure, what will happen? The far located amino acids, that means in a linear chain or in a primary structure, very far located amino acids, they came near to the each other, right? And they make up a active site. Just to give you example, let's say example of lysosome. In one variety of lysosome enzyme, it contain 129 amino acids, right? Now, there are total 129 amino acids in a linear chain, but amino acid number 35, 52, 62, 63, 101 and 108. These 6 amino acids, which are located far from each other. See, this is the 35 number, this is 52 number. Okay, there is so much gap. But because of extensive folding, these all amino acids come near to the each other. And by coming near to the each other, they make up this active site. Now, this particular amino acid in this lysosome, what they do? They provide one unique microenvironment. And in this microenvironment, the desired reaction of lysosome is carried out, which is the ideal one. Okay, and various enzyme has been examined, and it was found that generally these amino acids which are located at active site, these are mostly acidic amino acids, or there may be a basic amino acids. Mostly acidic and basic are there, and in addition to that, serine and cysteine, these amino acids are commonly found at the active site. And if you ask me which is the most common amino acid found at the active site, then it is a serine. Serine is the most common amino acid which is found at the active site. So this is the most common amino acid at active site. Now, as you can see, that out of 129 amino acids, only 6 amino acids are present or making active site. So you can easily get an idea that active site is very tiny or very little part of large enzyme molecule, right? So active site is very tiny or very small if you compared with the large enzyme molecule. In my earlier diagram, in this diagram, I had shown this active site disproportionately large, okay, just for the clarity of diagram. But if we talk about reality, enzyme molecule is very, very large, like this big, okay, and its active site is very small, like this man, this much, okay. And we know that only this active site is responsible for the binding as well as catalysis of the reaction. Then you might question that if only this part is required for that crucial reaction, why such a big enzyme molecule is required? Why nature had selected such a big molecule? So this remaining amino acid, which is making this remaining part of enzyme, they are not useless. Then why this remaining amino acids, or you can say remaining part of enzyme, is there? It has also some crucial function. See, as I told you earlier, that because of the tertiary structure, active site is created. So if this other amino acid had not gone under a folding and superfolding, this active site could not be created. So one major role of this remaining amino acid, we can say that they scaffold to create three-dimensional active site. Other role includes that this other remaining part of enzyme, it may act as a regulatory site for the enzyme. Many enzymes, their action is regulated. So such a regulatory molecules, they bind over here, okay? So which is called as a regulatory site. Suppose this is the regulatory site. So let's say insulin, which is regulating this enzyme, it comes and bind over here and then regulate the activity of this active site. Then third important function of this remaining part is that this part, it is helpful in the interaction with other protein. So it interact with other proteins. Last but not a least is very interesting aspect of this remaining part. Suppose the desired substrate comes and collide at this part, right? This is not the active site, so reaction will not take place. But many enzyme has a unique arrangement of amino acid. So what will does is that when substrate collides over here, it will guide the substrate molecules towards the active site. So once substrate has collided over here, slowly the substrate molecule will move along the surface of enzyme and it will reach to the active site. So this interesting aspect, we can say that it guides the substrate S to the active site. Now the next aspect is that about active site is that active site, it also contains coenzyme or cofactor. Now what is the meaning of this? Suppose this is the active site, okay? Now in this active site, some part of the active site in some enzyme, it is made up of coenzyme or cofactor. So if coenzyme or cofactors are not there, then active site is not properly formed. And that is the reason actually that some enzymatic reaction, they require coenzyme or cofactors. Now coming to the next point, active site is the complementary to substrate. Now what is the meaning of this? Suppose this is the substrate, right? Small triangle. And this is the active site. So as you can see, the shape of active site is complementary to the substrate. So that shape, when it is complementary, we call it as a geometric complementarity, right? Now there is not only geometric complementarity, but there is also electronic complementarity. What does it mean? Suppose this substrate has a positive charge over here and negative charge at these two places, then its corresponding active site will have a negative charge over here and positive charge over here. So what will happen? This substrate can properly fit into this active site and that attraction force will be there, right? So electronic complementarity, it makes sure that attraction between substrate and enzyme is maintained. So remember, there is geometric, that is shape related, as well as electronic complementarity is there. The last but not a least about the active site is that active site is not rigid. It is not rigid. Rather, it is a flexible. See, sometime active site in some enzyme, active site looks like this. I am giving just example. And its corresponding substrate is like this triangle. Okay. So, what happens? Initially, binding between this enzyme and this substrate occurs. So, that binding looks like this. This is the active site. This is the enzyme. And here, this substrate binds. Here, as you can see, that there is no any 100% complementarity, geometric complementarity. But as soon as substrate and this enzyme and this substrate binds, it will lead to conformational change in this enzyme. And so, this conformation changes, it leads to change of this active site shape to like this. And then it can properly and tightly bind with the substrate, right? And this thing has been confirmed by the X-ray crystallography. Remember, this induced fit model is not observed in all the enzyme, but in many enzyme, it is observed. Okay, and this model where after binding with the substrate, its active site comes into proper shape, it is called as an induced fit model. So, these were the salient feature of the active site. I hope that everything regarding active site is clear. If you still have any query or confusion, please write it down in the comment section below. Thank you.